This left part, the say a bare feet path, bare feet walk in the forest. It was really, really nice. Okay, so that's a little bit of information about our trip. So now I'm gonna see if we can find where we are in Belgium. Well, we're in Brussels, I should say. We are pretty central, I think. Let me see. I'm just trying to make sure my cat isn't. My cat just jumped on top of the desk that I'm sitting at. Sint-Katelijnenstraat, Sint-Katerin. Here you can see. Brussels, I think, officially is dual-lingual. There are two official languages, although in my experience, I think I've visited Brussels twice. In my experience, most people, you know, just on the streets and in stores and everywhere, they tend to speak French. Now, I've only been there twice, so that might have been coincidental, but I feel like basically, even though it's dual lingual, here you can see the border, Flanders, Brussels. Brussels, oh, Flanders, even here, and then here there's Wallonia. So Wallonia basically is the French part, Flanders is the Dutch part, and then Brussels sort of is a world by itself, I guess. So let's see, I feel like we are somewhere in the old city center, just because it all looks pretty old. Hey, Sainte-Catherine. Here, a church, Sainte-Catherine. Sainte-Catherine, yes. I think that means that the street should be there too. So here is the Plaza Sainte-Catherine. So rue Sainte-Catherine, rue main street. So yes, this street, we are somewhere here. Okay, let's take a look around again. Do we see this church? There is a marché, a market here. Plus Sainte-Catherine. Okay, so this is the plus where the square meets the street, basically. Yeah, so basically where I am right now. So let's go back to the start. Oh yeah, this is the church, clearly. And then we are Oude Graanmarkt, Vieux Marché. Okay, I think we should be able to find that. Let me see. Yes, the Oude Graanmarkt, that's over here. So we're close to the street, yes. I think that means we are about here. Let's guess. Yes, 5,000 points. A perfect score. Even though I was 9 meters off, but. Okay, then, as you can see here, there are some hills in Belgium. As a matter of fact, there are even some mountains. Let me zoom in here, this southern part, as the Ardennen in Dutch, and they are quite large mountains, although not as high as the Alps, I think, but kind of similar. But I must say, I live in the Netherlands, and the Netherlands is totally flat, so I'm easily impressed when it comes to mountains, but they're definitely more than hills. And then here I was for this last vacation near Hasselt, basically here near Maastricht. That's quite hilly. Also, this southern little part of the Netherlands is also hilly. So here, I would think we maybe are at least in the vicinity of the Alps. No, the Ardennes. There is some water here, so we are down below at this point in the valley. And it kind of feels hard to know where exactly I am. So let's just... something going on over there, like a fire. I'm just gonna walk a little bit and see if I can find some sort of sign. I don't know, just anything with words on it. It's not going that fast. Let's see. I think I'm just gonna make a guess because I feel like I can go on forever and that will be not the most interesting for you guys to watch, even though it looks kind of peaceful with the woods. So let me think. I think we are basically somewhere here. And as we can see, we are near a little river. It's... oh wow, there are a lot. okay. Let's see, can we somehow see where the mountains are? Not really, right? So... I'm just gonna guess somewhere down here. Yeah, basically, I don't know. Okay, so we have this little road that goes alongside. Basically, I'm not just looking for road that is sort of desolate, something like this, but it has to go alongside a little river. So well, that's actually, yeah, like this, maybe like this. I have no idea if this is correct, but I just, I mean, it can be. Well, if you zoom out, it wasn't too bad. Let's see where we were. Yeah, basically something like there. Okay, next round. Okay, water, boats, huge roads. Katelijnstraat, Jachthaven. Okay, that is not yet telling me like the name of a city or something like that. So let's go back a little bit. Vince. Still, I do not have a name of a places like this, like the streets and the infrastructure basically, kind of looks like the Netherlands. Can't read this as well. Maybe like this. Here there is a water going on. Could be here. But let's see, we could also be here. Kind of same story. Or here. Okay, so it says Maaldegem. And the E40 to Brussels. But the E40, okay, sure. Over there. So where is Maaldegem? Let's zoom in a little bit more and see if we can find Maaldegem. I feel like that's gonna help us. Even though I don't see it. I'm now zoomed in a little bit more. I feel like the Netherlands and Belgium have a nice coastline with beautiful beaches. The only thing is that the weather can be wonderful. Oh, here's Maaldegem, but it can also be not as wonderful. So let's see, we are somewhere close to Maaldegem, but then there's also this place where you can go. I don't really know. Are we somewhere here then? Okay, let's try and walk a little bit further. The thing is, the weather can be nice, but it can also be kind of not all that sunny, rainy sometimes, although I must say that probably Belgium, being a little bit more to the south than the Netherlands, has a slightly higher chance of good weather. Baron Ruzet, look at this. This is beautiful, right? And this could also be like that in the Netherlands, a little village somewhere. Okay, so I was looking at the city as a whole, but I should have looked only at the inside, and then it is, look. So we are somewhere here. and then near the water. And then it both tells us the E40 in Maldegem. So maybe we are somewhere here. But there is also this little places for boats. Let's see if we can find that. Somewhere around here. Let's just say that we are here. Okay. I could have turned this into a perfect score, I guess, if I wanted to continue to search. However, I think this video shouldn't take an hour, mostly because my son is taking his afternoon nap, and I don't think he will be asleep for that long. So for ASMR purposes, it's best if I finish this video before he wakes up. So two more rounds to go. I do like this round. I do feel like it shows how versatile Belgium is. Now we have like a village, I think. One of the big differences between Belgium and the Netherlands is that in Belgium, houses tend to be way more diverse. In the Netherlands, we have more like rules about the height of the house or the color of the roof. I mean, you can choose yourself, but there are all these rules that you have to adhere to. And I feel like in Belgium, it's way more random. And that leads to more chaotic and more surprising architecture, especially if you look at the whole of a village or a city. Whether you think it's a good thing or a bad thing, I think that very much depends on taste. Personally, I like the chaotic style of it. I like the idea of not having many rules. Having that said, it's kind of hit or miss for me. Sometimes I think Belgium is beautiful, and sometimes I feel like, oh wow, maybe some rules wouldn't be too bad. So it kind of, yeah, pros and cons. Hey, a little doggy. But I think I like it. I'm kind of looking for a name. Yeah, I was gonna say, it does feel French to me. Rue de la Croix Blanche. That means the street of the White Cross, I think. Like I said, I did study French in high school, but that was a long time ago. Rue de l'Église Hanout. Hanout. Okay, so Hanout is probably, I've never heard of Hanout, but I think spa water comes from the brand, the mineral water. It might even be the name of like going to the spa. I don't know actually, but it just feels like it's sort of like this relaxation resort.
Northeast.
straight road. This one in Brugge was good, and then my guesses were